Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1699, random but no repeats. Well, hey, yesterday Kris asked about generating a 26 by 26 grid where it was filled with letters from A through Z randomly. But now today we learned that Kris is actually trying to make sure that there's no repeats in each row. So every row contains all of the letters from A through Z, we don't want any repeats. So we're going to ask for the character of row of A65. That's asking for character 65, and I'll copy that down, 26. That should get us the letters A through Z, right? And then right here, equal rand, that just gives us a random decimal from 0 to 1, 15 digits of precision. So in theory, there's going to be no duplicates here, certainly not in this small population of 26. So let's sort column A. We want the equal small of all of those values over there, F4 to lock that down, and then row of A1. That's a geeky way of writing the number 1. The beautiful thing about that is as we copy it down, it'll give us the first smallest, the second smallest, third smallest, fourth smallest, and so on. Okay, now let's get the letters over here. So we're going to use equal index of those letters, F4, and we want a number from 1 to 26, and so what we're going to ask for is the match of this number in this range over here. Press F4, comma, 0. All right, you notice that every time I enter a new formula, everything changes, but that's okay, because now we're getting the complete set of 26 letters. All right, now let's twist those letters, so equal index of this range, F4. Now here I want the first one, so I'm going to ask for the column of A1, and as I copy that across, we should get this set of data twisted sideways, transposed, but it's transposing a formula, not just doing a single transpose. Now at this point, we can probably create a data table. So put the numbers 1 to 26 down here, because we want 26 answers. Select this whole range, and data, what-if analysis, data table. The row input cell, we're going to leave blank. Column input cell, we're going to take each one of these numbers one at a time and just put them, I don't care where, it doesn't matter, just any random cell. Click OK. And what we should end up with there is a 26 by 26 grid, random letters, and each row has every letter exactly once. A lot harder than what we did yesterday. Yesterday we just generated random numbers. When you need random without repeats, it becomes much more difficult. Now, thinking about this, did we even have to put these letters here, A through Z, or could we have actually, once we have that match is returning the numbers from 1 to 26. So if we're returning 1 to 26, we could ask for the equal CHAR of 64 plus the match, and that would also randomly get us 26 letters, and we don't have to put the letters over here at all. We just need the rand function. Look, you can see, I don't know if you were able to see it, the little spinning circle. It's actually starting to take a little bit of time to recalculate this now, because it has to basically sort with the formula 26 times. A lot more complicated to get the 26 by 26 grid where each row contains every letter exactly once. All right, well, again, thanks to Kris for sending that question in. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.